it's all been saved for you. Repair, not in part.
I don't know anything like that. I just don't want to run over time. You got me? All right, cool, cool, cool.
Testing. Oh, yeah, there we go. All right. All right. Hi, everybody. Hi, hi, hi. Hello. Oh, that sounds even fuller. So, I guess no introductions. I'll introduce myself. Most of you already know me. You should know me. My name is Brennan Booz. I'm originally from Rochester, New York. Now living in Little Rock, Arkansas. And I'm here actually to talk to you about a wonderful program through the Global Ministries of the United Methodist Church, the Community Developers Program. Awesome program. Start with a little story. There was a young kid, about 16 years old, who went to a youth conference similar to this one. And it was his first time really leaving his home state, going, you know, to a foreign land to him, and being at a youth conference with kids his age and actually having fun at the conference. It was his first time, and he went, enjoyed himself, and he was asked a question that he, to this day, he really never understood his answer. He was asked by one of his mentors, "Do you want to be the MC for our worship?" And you know, he had a moment in his head where it was kind of like, you know, his mind responded before he really thought about it, and he said yes. And then he reminded himself about 3 seconds later, like, "Yo, you're shy. You don't talk well in front of people. You don't really talk, period." And you know, when he said yes, you know, he can't take it back at that point. So it was like, you know, what are we gonna do? Are we gonna go with it, or are we just gonna not show up? So he showed up, and man, it was just a life-changing experience. My first time being in a place where I honestly, like, I could feel the presence of God just, like, throughout my body. It felt like I had an out-of-body experience. As we were going in the worship service, there came a moment where the choir sang, and they really, like, the presence of God was heavy, real heavy. And I was standing behind the podium, and I'm sitting there, and in my head, you know, me and God are having this conversation, this kind of argument. And I'm hearing all these things, you know, that you know, I would hear a pastor say in those moments. And I'm sitting back, and I'm like, man, that would sound great if it came from somebody. And God's sitting there telling me, like, "Hey, so go to the mic and say it." And I'm like, oh no, that's not my role, nah. And so me and God are having this back and forth, and I'm trying to remind God, like, "God, yo, like, you know, this is my first time emceeing anything. I don't talk, you know, well in public. I don't talk from stages. I'm already nervous enough. Why in the world would I walk up to this mic?" And as that argument was going on, one of my mentors tapped me on the shoulder and whispered in my ear. She said, "Hey, God's telling you to say something. Walk to the mic and say it." And I did it. And my life has never been the same since. To see youth, people that were actually my age at the time, at the altar, you know, bowing and, you know, praising God and in tears because of what I was saying. And I know the words weren't for me. Like, it was the first time I really, like, people tell me I preached a sermon, like, that's the first sermon I ever preached, but I didn't have notes. I wasn't prepared. Like, there was no 3 points, you know, there was no introduction, conclusion. I didn't do a call to the altar, anything you're supposed to do as a preacher, but it was the first sermon I ever preached. And like I didn't, in my mind, I'm sitting and I'm thinking, like, what are you saying? Like, where are these words coming from? Where is this coming from? You know, all you're pouring out into people, and you are struggling with, you know, all I could think of was everything I was struggling with personally. You're struggling with, you know, your own personal identity. You're struggling with your own, you know, self-confidence, self-esteem. And yet you're standing here and you have the ears of everyone in the room because of how God is moving through you. And that experience was afforded to me because of the Community Developers Program, a moment that truly changed my life. And is partially why, you know, I'm emceeing Youth 2015. so that, yeah, actually, you know, had I known, I would have brought the video and shown you the video from that. And I still, like, I watch it and I still get chills. Because I know I can look at it, and even as I look in my own face, I'm like, yo, who is this kid? Like, knowing myself at that time, and it's like, yo, who is this dude talking? Like, I don't think I've ever met him. I need to, me and him need to be acquainted, especially since we have the same name. But it, like, it's just not, that's not me. But, you know, understanding that this journey that God has me on, and the opportunities that have been afforded to me because of the great work of the Community Developers Program has really, you know, it's been a blessing to my life. And I'm here to talk about the Community Developers Program, and kind of, you know, my the best way for me to do that is to give you bits and pieces of my personal testimony. So statistically, you know, I fit into most statistics of a young black male. Grew up in a one-parent home, you know, lived in poverty, was actually homeless for a while with my mother and siblings. was the class clown. Never, you know, fully realized his potential in high school and elementary school and middle school. You know, lived in inner city, went to inner city schools, you know, so like it something my pastor back home said, when I graduated high school, my father never graduated high school, but when I graduated, he said, you know, you beat all the statistics. And for myself, when he said it, I was just like, I didn't beat anything. I didn't feel like I had beaten anything. I felt like, and I especially didn't do it by myself. There were so many people that were around me that helped me to accomplish what I had accomplished. And at that point, you know, graduating high school was huge for me. But I knew that that wasn't the end of my journey. I've only seen my high school diploma once. I actually, once I got it, I gave it to my mother, and I told my mother to give it to my father, because he had never graduated. And I didn't feel like that was my diploma. Like, that wasn't something I really did for myself. That was something I did for him. I wanted to graduate to show, you know, my father that he wasn't a failure. And that was a struggle for me, because me and my father, we never really had, you know, we never really had a great relationship. He was, you know, in the prison system for a while, and, you know, it was 16 before. I was 16 when he got out, and so we tried to build a relationship after that. But it just never, you know, it never was the Cosbys, you know. It was never the Cosby situation. It was more like, you know, when we chilled. In between, it was whatever. But, you know, it was the first time I got connected with the Community Developers Program was in South Carolina in 2005. And one of the things They have a program, Justice Youth Program, and I was selected to be a part of it. And when we first met, we all sat down and said, we kind of made, you know, the 5-year, 3-year, 5-year, and 10-year goals. And one of my goals, which I was reminded of after I graduated, was to create a program for young people in general, young people who grew up without fathers. And my mentor, JT Jackson, actually called me on my graduation day and reminded me of that and brought me to tears. Because I had told them at the time I didn't expect my father to be at my graduation, but he came. And having that support system is honestly one of the key things of the, you know, Community Developers Program. The network that you build through the program is just, it's incredible. It's amazing because people know me and I don't even necessarily know them. I just have to, you know, kind of do the thing where you shake the hand and you kind of hope that they say something that reminds you of where you met them or how they know you. It doesn't happen that often, but when it does happen, you know, I'm happy because then I'm like, oh, okay, I do know you. But you can't show it too much, you know. It's crazy. But, you know, the network of it and the support that you get through the program is, like, amazing. You might meet someone in the program once, but, you know, throughout, you create lifetime relationships just through the network, just through talking to people, and you get resource from these very same people. They give you information, you give them information. It's an amazing network. And actually, executive secretary, is that it? Executive secretary is actually sitting in here, and Lakeisha Reed, she's a third row, so you guys can ask her a bunch of questions about it afterwards, because I know I didn't give a lot of information about the program, but it's an amazing, amazing program, and I can tell you that I would not be here or the person I am today without the program. I would not. There's no way. I was connected. I was non-denominational and got connected to the United Methodist Church through that program. I found my calling as a communicator and marketer. I'm in school right now, double majoring with communications and marketing because of a youth program that I became affiliated with because of the Community Developers Program. So I think my time is up. And I hope you all have enjoyed it. I hope you all take time, mob Lakeisha, ask her about the program, ask her about how you can get involved. You can ask me too, but I'm probably gonna direct you to Lakeisha, so it'd be better if you just went to the source. I hope you all enjoy the rest of your time here. Lakeisha can give you all the information you need about the wonderful Community Developers Program. Thank you all for listening to me babble for 10 minutes. I hope you heard something that, you know, inspires you to help your community and go beyond.